In this video, let's learn about Prim's algorithm. Prim's algorithm is a greedy method to find the minimum spanning tree of a given graph. First, let's understand how a tree differs from a graph. If you take a graph, it is simply a set of vertices connected to each other with some edges. There are no other specific rules for a graph. Whereas all trees are graphs, but in order to be qualified as a tree, if you pick any two vertices, say here, if you pick A and C, they should be connected just with one well-defined path and there should not be more than one path between the two vertices. If you pick A and C here, they can be connected in this path or by this way. But in trees, there is just one well-defined path between any two vertices. In other words, you can say that a graph may contain a loop or a cycle, but trees cannot contain cycles. To understand better, you can consider A as the root node and you can realign the tree like this, or you can consider B as the root node and the tree can be realigned like this. Now, what is a spanning tree? A spanning tree is simply a tree in which all the vertices are included, all the vertices are connected. We cannot leave a vertex like this that is disconnected from the rest of the vertices, so this cannot be a spanning tree. Now, a graph can have more than one spanning trees. If you take this graph and ignore the edge between A and E, then we get a spanning tree. If we ignore this edge, we get another spanning tree. Similarly, we can construct three more spanning trees for the same graph. Minimum spanning tree. The term minimum comes into picture only when we have weighted graphs like this. For all these five spanning trees, if we calculate the total cost, we get five different values. The one with the minimum total cost becomes the minimum spanning tree. Minimum spanning trees are not necessarily unique. You can have more than one minimum spanning tree for a given graph. Why should we find minimum spanning tree? See here, the vertices of the graph could represent different cities or different locations in a city. And if we have to connect all these different points with telephone cables or electric cables or hydraulic pipelines, the aim would be to connect all these points without missing any of them, at the same time minimizing the cost. So that's where minimum spanning tree plays an important role. There are several other indirect applications as well, like approximation of traveling salesman problem, real-time phase verification, amino acid sequencing, particle interaction, Ethernet bridging protocols. Let's take this graph and try to construct a minimum spanning tree for this graph by following a greedy technique. To begin with, we can pick any vertex. I am picking A. Consider this A to be disconnected from the rest of the graph. Now, our intention will be to somehow connect A to any of these three vertices. The edge weights are 1, 2 and 4. Since we are following a greedy technique here, we will obviously choose this edge as this has the minimum weight. Now, A and D are part of the spanning tree that we are constructing. Now, we need to connect this path to the rest of the graph. We have quite a few options here. A could be connected to E, A could be connected to B, or D could be connected to C. Both these edges have the same weight, so we can pick any of them. Let's pick this one, AB. Now, on attempting to connect this with the rest of the graph, we again have three options, and we would prefer the one with the minimum weight here, DC. Now, to connect this with the rest of the graph, we have two options and both have equal weights of 4. Let's pick this one, AE. Now, to connect this part with the rest of the graph, we have three options. We always choose the minimum edge, so let's take 3 here. Now, to connect this with the node G, we have two options and we would prefer this one because it has the weight of 2. As we add more and more vertices to the spanning tree that we are constructing, we ensure that during each addition, we select the least value. Certain greedy algorithms may not give the optimum results all the time, but Prim's algorithm always promises a minimum spanning tree. By contradiction, if we assume that Prim's algorithm is not giving us a minimum spanning tree, it means that in the process, we have picked a wrong edge. We did not pick the minimum value at some point of time, which will never happen if we implemented the algorithm correctly. Alright, now instead of giving the names as A, B, C, let's change it to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Let's try to write the pseudocode for this. Say we are given with the adjacency matrix of the graph. This visual is just for our imagination. We only have this matrix as the input. How are we going to express this spanning tree as a result? We can simply have an array, a parent array, which could tell us what is the parent for each of the vertex. See here, in this spanning tree that we have constructed, if you take the vertex 1, 0 is the parent of 1. Similarly, 0 is the parent of 3 and 0 is the parent of 4 as well. So if we have such information in an array and also this adjacency matrix, we can easily construct this spanning tree. So our code should be able to give us a result like this. We are going to start with some vertex and then we are going to add more vertices to our spanning tree, right? So we obviously need some kind of Boolean array which could tell us what are all the vertices that have already been added to the spanning tree and what are all the vertices that are yet to be added to the spanning tree. So let's have an array for that. And we can initialize it as all false in the beginning. We can pick 0th vertex as the first vertex. In the Boolean array, we can mark the 0th vertex as true as it is now part of the spanning tree. Moreover, the starting vertex cannot have a parent. So we are assuming that the parent of the starting vertex is minus 1. Now we can go to this 0th row of the adjacency matrix. It will tell us all the connections from 0. So we have 3 edges with the edge weights 2, 1 and 4. We would like to pick the minimum value here, which is 1, and it belongs to the third vertex. The column number is 3 here. So we include this 3 also in our spanning tree. We can mark true here for the third vertex. And also, now the parent of 3 is 0. We have included this vertex 3 by connecting it to 0, right? So here the parent of the third vertex is 0. Now we have 2 vertices in our spanning tree. We have to loop through both of these rows and pick the minimum value, but also ensure not to pick the value that we have already picked. See here, 1 has already been picked. We have to pick the next minimum value. As we add more and more vertices to the spanning tree, this process is going to get difficult, right? To pick the minimum value. So we kind of need to have a workaround here. To make the process simple and quicker, we can have an array in which we are storing the minimum key values for each of the vertices. We can initialize the values to some maximum integer value for all the vertices except for the first one. We can assign a 0 for the vertex that we are going to pick first, because we are always going to pick the vertex from this key array which has the minimum value. So initially we pick this 0th vertex. Since 0 is our first vertex, we go to the 0th row of this matrix and loop through this row. While looping through this row itself, we can update the corresponding key values 2, 1 and 4. If we update like this, it will be very easy for us to pick the next minimum value. See here, 0 we have already picked. You can just cross check with the Boolean array. Now the next minimum value is 1, which corresponds to third vertex. So we can include that vertex to our spanning tree now. What we can basically do is, while looping through each of the row, we can just look up this table. If it already has a minimum value, we can ignore. But if we have a better value now, while looping through the row, we can update that better value to the key array so that we always pick the minimum value. We can start with the pseudo code. You can understand better as we progress. We can initialize 3 different arrays for parent, minimum spanning tree Boolean array and the key array. We can first initialize the Boolean array to all false, and the key array can be initialized to all infinity, that is some maximum value for integer. We can now change the key of the 0th vertex to 0 so that this get picked first, and then the parent of the 0th vertex will be minus 1. Now our first step is to pick a vertex, right? We always pick the minimum value from this key array. So for each vertex we present in the graph, we just loop through this key array and pick the minimum value, but also make sure that that minimum value has not been picked already. You can find it by just looking up the Boolean table. We pick that vertex only if the value is false in the Boolean table. Only then it has not already been included in the tree. If it becomes true, then that vertex has already been included in the spanning tree, so we should not pick that minimum value. We have picked a vertex k. Now this k has to be included in our spanning tree, right? So we can just mark the MST of the kth vertex as true. Now we have to loop through this row of the adjacency matrix, right? So for each vertex present in the graph, if the value is less than the value present in the key table, we have to update the key table, right? So we just have to compare each of these values to the value already present in the key table. Since we are dealing with an adjacency matrix here, there will be lot of zeros as well, and we should ignore the zeros. So only if the value is greater than zero and if it is less than the key value already present in the key table, we have to update the key value present in the key table. So here in this case, on comparing, we can update these three values 2, 1 and 4 to the key table. For all these three vertices, see here, this is the first vertex, this is vertex number 3 and this is vertex number 4, right? For all these three vertices, 0 is the parent. So we can mark the parent array as well. This is definitely not the final value of the parent table. If we are able to find a better edge, then we will update the key value table and also the parent. We do all these steps inside the loop. So now we go back to this step to find the next minimum value, right? The next minimum value is 1 because 0 has already been marked as true. So we have to pick this value 1, which corresponds to the third vertex. So we are marking the third vertex as a part of spanning tree. Just make this as true in the Boolean table. Now we need to loop through the third row of the matrix. Now we start comparing the value one by one. Here we have a 1 and a 0. We don't have to update. Moreover, this first one has already been included in the tree, right? So we don't even have to compare for the key values that have already been included in the spanning tree. So we can add one more check to save some time. We can compare only if those vertices are not been already part of the spanning tree. So if MST of V is false, only then we update the key values. If it is already true, we don't have to update. Now this value is 2 here, but the corresponding value in the key table is infinity. On comparing, we are now getting a smaller value and we can update that value in the key table. The parent of this node would be 3 because we are in the third row now. We are looking up the adjacency matrix for this third vertex. So this vertex is now the parent for all these connections. So we can update a 3 here in the parent array as well. Going back to the top of the loop, we have to pick the next minimum value. We have 2 2s here as the next minimum value. We obviously go with the first available option. We pick this 2. This corresponds to the first vertex of the graph. So we include this first vertex to our spanning tree. Just mark the corresponding Boolean value as true. Now on looping through this first row of the matrix, we have 2 values, 2 and 5. We don't have to update this 2 because the 0th vertex is already part of spanning tree. So take this value 5. When we compare it with the corresponding value present in the key table, we see that it already has a smaller value, right? There is no point in updating a bigger value to the key table. We always want minimum values in the key table. So we just ignore this edge 5. We can just remove it out of picture. We don't need it anymore because we have a better option. That is, this vertex here, we have already updated that there is a connection from parent 3 with an edge weight of 2. So we are now ignoring this connection. Okay. Now again going to top of the loop and picking the next minimum value. This 2 here, it corresponds to vertex number 2, this vertex. So we are including that as part of spanning tree. So we can mark this value as true here. Now looping through this row, we have 3 values, 5, 2 and 4. We see that this 5 and 2, the corresponding vertices have already been added to the spanning tree. So there is no use of comparing these 2 values. We just need this 4. If we compare the corresponding value in the key table, we have an infinity here. So this has to be updated. We update that as 4. And the corresponding parent should also be updated. We are in row number 2, right? So here the k value is 2 and that is the parent for this vertex. Now taking the next minimum value from the key table, it is 4. It corresponds to the fourth vertex. So include the fourth vertex as part of the minimum spanning tree. Mark the corresponding value as true in the Boolean array. On looping through the fourth row of the adjacency matrix, this is the fourth row. I am taking this one as the zeroth row. So this is the fourth row. On looping through this, the value 4 here is useless because the corresponding vertex has already been added to the spanning tree. Now take this number 3. The corresponding value in the key table is 4. It means that this fifth vertex right here has some other connection with an edge weight of 4. You can exactly know to which node it is connected with the help of the parent table. It is actually connected to vertex number 2 with an edge weight of 4. See, 5 right here is actually connected to vertex number 2 with an edge weight of 4. But now we are finding a better option with an edge weight of 3 here. So this 3 has to be updated instead of 4. We have found a lesser key value now. So just update this as 3, and the corresponding parent should also be updated. The corresponding parent is vertex 4 because we are in this fourth row. So here also we update the corresponding parent. And also there is one more value, 6. It is already infinity in the table, so this also has to be updated. Let's make it as 6 and the corresponding parent as 4. Because now k value is 4. Now picking the next minimum value, it should be this one, the fifth vertex, because the value was 3. So we mark the corresponding boolean value as true and include the fifth vertex also to our spanning tree. All these values are true. We just have to compare this last value. This is 2 here, but the key value that is already present is 6. We now have a better value, so this has to be updated. So make this 6 as 2, and also the corresponding parent has to be updated. Now the parent is 5. See, the node number 6 right here, we initially had this edge, but now we are updating to this edge as this is a better option now to connect 6 to the spanning tree instead of this edge. So the corresponding parent is 5, we update that as well. We can remove this edge itself, we don't need that anymore. Now we just have only one vertex left. We can pick that vertex, the last one, the sixth vertex. Now on looping through the table also, all the values are true, so we don't have to update anymore. All nodes have already been added to the spanning tree, which means our spanning tree is complete and the parent array that we have here is final. Just with the help of this parent array and the adjacency matrix, we can easily reconstruct this spanning tree visually. Coming to the time complexity, we have two loops here. We are looping through all the vertices. So the time complexity will be O of n square, n being proportional to the number of vertices present in the graph. To improve the efficiency of Prim's algorithm, we can use a priority queue to select the minimum key value, or you can use a binary heap.